Okay, team. So our job today is to make an ammonia plant, and it needs to be as ergonomically efficient as possible.
I expect nothing less from him. We are literally a paper supply company, and he is giving us an impossible assignment that takes years of chemical engineering fundamentals to understand.
I really just want Brad and Angelina to get back together. I really don't care about an ammonia plant.
As long as I have Jesus, we will finish this project.
I don't actually have to do any work. I'm just a secretary.
Ammonia is very useful, not to mention I have a team of incredibly dedicated workers that will work to all hours of the night, practically like 3 in the morning, to get this project done. Ammonia is such a useful compound. It can be used as a household cleaner and to get...
This thing is out of clothes.
A bigger reactor.
We're coding in MATLAB. What a horrible phrase. We're coding in MATLAB. It's driving us insane. It means we'll worry for the rest of our days. It's our bug-filled code. We've lost all hope.
We are coding in MATLAB.
Like my mom always said, life's like an ammonia plant. You never know what you're gonna get.
The forest, we do know what we want. We have a stream of nitrogen, hydrogen, and argon coming in and entering a heat exchanger. In the heat exchanger, the feed is heated up to the temperature to go into the reactor. The reactor then gives us our ammonia. This is fed to a separator where we get a liquid and a vapor stream. The vapor stream contains all of our gases that did not react, as well as some vapor ammonia. And then the rest goes into liquid ammonia. Some of the vapor stream is then fed into a recycle stream and a purge stream, where the recycle stream brings some of our feed back to the beginning to be reused in the process. This gives us a 96% efficiency. Additionally, we get 200,000 tons of ammonia a year. So we do know what we want to get.
But Mama said we don't know what we're going to get.
So for our design, we've decided on a recycle over purge ratio of 20. With this new optimization, we actually get a conversion of close to 100%.
Yes, and our heat reactor is going to be producing a lot of steam, which we'll be piping to the heat exchanger, and we'll actually have excess steam, which will be used to power the plant.
So with all of this optimization, we should be getting a profit of $93 million every year.
Wow.
And with this design, we can use the smallest reactor size, right?
Right, most cost efficient.
Cool.
Say hello to my little friend.
Okay, just a few more minutes until we get the mass balance organized. After this, I'm running a strongly worded letter to the chemical engineering department.
I love you, Jack.
No, don't say your goodbyes.
I'm stuck on the code.
It's okay. You're gonna get out of this, and you're gonna go on to run an ammonia plant. You're gonna make ammonia. You're gonna get hit. Don't give up. Never give up. It's okay. You can keep doing it. I believe in you. Don't give up hope. Promise me that. Don't give up hope. You can do this, Code.
I promise.
Never let go.
I'll never let go, Jack. I'll never let go.
Michael, wake up. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You can see, we've worked very hard on our ammonia plant. With a conversion factor close to 100%, we are the best option for your company and the environment. So buy a ton of ammonia from Dunder Mifflin Paper and Ammonia Company. And we don't just mean one ton.